Good, good girl. Good, girl.
Soon if we're not careful.
A banished prince, a servant girl who's really a
good job, Arthur.
And a wicked stepmother. Are you ever intending to do any work, Miss?
Oh, Miss Grimshaw. The desert
good
rose.
Job, Mr. Morgan.
You know, my dear, some people say you're an old crow. But I tell them that's nonsense. I tell them you just keep one in your ear.
Oh, you animal.
What, you just keep crows up your sleeve?
That's for me to know, dear boy.
Pearson. Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Son, the best man amongst us. You okay, Arthur?
Never better.
Me neither. Me neither. This Mr. Miller is a hell of a writer. Like a modern-day Elijah.
she is.
Hi there, Arthur.
Talk to you for a second, Dutch.
Of course.
Well, it's Miss O'Shea. She doesn't seem too happy.
That's her business.
Well, I hope so. I hope she doesn't make it all our business. She's got a temper on her, Dutch.
She is not the only one of us with a temper, Miss Grimshaw.
Well, I don't like it. Not now.
It's like I always say. There's two theories when it comes to arguing with young women, and neither of them work.
Oh, I've heard you say that nonsense before, and it did not impress then any more than it does now.
Thank you.
at least try to make an effort with the boy?
If it'll shut you up, I'll try. But fathering ain't nothing I know about.
Here's a hint. Act like you ain't a selfish, bloodthirsty moron.
You mean lie?
Shut up.
Saying them things about me.
I'm the dumb strumpet. Now, get
Hi there,
off.
Arthur.
Look at me. Look at me. You little...
Damn you. And you be careful before you hit me again, you goddamn moron. Dutch or no Dutch, you'll be up there with the angels playing harp before sunset. You hear me?
What's going on with you?
All of you talking about me behind my back.
Oh, you're losing it. Well, I should get back to it.
All right there?
You okay?
She's lucky that's all she got.
She's going through a rough time of it. Okay, I'll catch you later then. Ladies?
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Hi.
Good book?
I'm allowed to take a break, Arthur.
I know. I'll leave you to it.
All right, Arthur.
Don't say it, Grimshaw.
Hi, ladies.
Make yourself useful, Miss Jones.
Kieran.
Yeah. See? You learn quick.
Gentlemen.
Hello, Arthur.
Morgan?
Forgotten about that storybook you lost.
Thanks so much, Uncle Arthur. Do you want to have this? I found it near camp.
Sure. Thanks, Jack.
Earn their cake, Mr. Morgan.
Leave me out of it, Miss Grimshaw.
Mm-hmm.
Marston.
Hey, Arthur.
You're keeping busy?
Trying to.
Mrs. Adler?
Hi.
Everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
No reason. Just making sure.
Okay, then.
Hi there, Arthur.
Mary Beth. Hang in there. We'll be back on track soon.
I'm fine, Arthur. Don't worry about me.
People want to eat or not?
keep your eyes open, Bill.
Hello, Arthur.
Sober, you watch your mouth.
My lady,
you joining us then?
Arthur?
Mrs. Abbott.
You gonna sit down instead of pacing about the place?
Managing not to kill Pearson?
Only just.
About the coach job?
Yeah, another run-in with the Cornwall Army.
Karen.
Strauss.
That's enough for me.
God help anyone tries to get past you.
Hey!
Dance with
Just like being a normal girl.
Oh, being normal's good, is it?
No. But aspects of it is. That's the problem.
Mr. Vanderlyn.
My pleasure, Miss Grimshaw. Still got it. Thanks for the dance.
Hey, you can have a dance anytime, Arthur Morgan.
Hi, folks.
Evening.
Hi to you.
Charles?
How are those fire arrows?
Good, thank you. What are these?
Oh, a little different. Poisoned arrows. My uncle showed me how to make these when I was very young.
Poisoned arrows?
Mm-hmm. Not very nice, but very effective. You get me some oleander, and I'll make you some.
Thank you. Like your new home?
I won't miss that other place, that's for sure.
Keep your nose clean.
Thank you.
Looking smart, as always.
One must have standards, dear boy.
Hello, sirs. This slob gonna have my bowels all gummed up. And boil a shoe?
sir.
Well, I think I'll call it a night.
I did. I cast out evil, and I helped people. I was a pompous ass. Really, I was. I forgot that I was doing God's work, and began to think that I was a god. What a fool. What a terrible, arrogant fool I was. A man of God. And then I met that little sticky black devil. Those little lumps of hell. Just a little back pain. Oh, this'll make it feel better. A gift from the gods. It got me by the throat. You all know that. You all laugh at me, pity and despise me, I'm sure, but forgive. At least forgive me, because all the silly things I do, all the lying and the stealing, somehow it isn't me. Or if it is, it isn't all of me. There's a different, better me stuck inside of here. Dutch sees it. And that's why he puts up with me when I'm sure the rest of you would cast me adrift. And that's why I love him, because he can forgive. Even when I can't forgive myself.
Hello.
You're one of us, Reverend. We'll always forgive you.
You will?
Well, maybe not always.
speaking to me at least.
Oh, it is always about your needs, isn't it? I have never known a woman with so many needs.
You don't know the first thing about a woman's needs.
How selfish are you? Are you even aware of the price on my head? The pressures I'm under?
If you'd only talk to me, I could help. I want to help you, Dutch, but there's this wall.
You can help by leaving me alone so I can actually think for once.
You're a bastard, Dutch Vanderlinde.